Mary, family, we will be there for you in whatever way you may need us. But let's all, you know what, let's be about God's business, being other-centered, not self-centered, but other-centered, reaching out, loving, encouraging. I want to leave you with this last set of scriptures in 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 and 14. The Word of God says, "Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind and have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him." Amen? Amen. We believe that. We believe that without a shadow of a doubt. Yes. Sure. Come on up.
Hi, everyone. My name's Philip. This is Dwayne. I'm one of the many grandchildren of my grandfather. So that being said, it took a lot for me to come up here. So I had to write something out, so sorry if I came a little unprepared, but good morning, I'm Philip. This is Frank. I'm Frank's grandson, and this is a young man you've all heard of. Dwayne. The young man my grandfather did such a good job on in every aspect in life. Not only did he teach him trades, and the strong value of labor and work, he also taught him some of the most valuable things in life: God, Jesus, and the value of what a fuller purse would bring you and your loved ones over time. About credit and keeping your debts in true order and staying on top of them so you're not worried with the next set of plans or obstacles the Lord has set out for you. Always be ready for anything and everything that may have a chance to be thrown at you. You know, before he passed, he kept trying to nail into my head that I needed to read his most sought-out book, The Richest Man in Babylon. I thought I was going to get some laughter from that. If you haven't already heard of it, I'm sure he would be truly grateful that I share it with you today. But the chances of him already mentioning it to each of you, I'm sure, is very high. With that being said, I was so reluctant and had little patience with myself to sit down and read the book. I finally started it, and I totally understand why he's been trying to push that darn thing into my path. I understand, Grandpa. I'm on page 33, and I promise I'll finish it and put all the wisdom it has to share with me into play. There are many stories and memories I could share with you today, but sadly, there's not enough time in the day for me to share all of them. But one memory I love to share is the fishing trip my grandfather and I had the opportunity to go on a little over a year ago. We went out of the Oxnard Harbor and fished a three-quarter day out by the Anacapa Islands. I was unsure the whole time for my grandfather due to his older age. But I'll tell you what, not only did he reel every fish he caught right up, he also had caught the biggest fish on the boat that day. The whole time I thought I might have needed to help him, I realized, no, it is I who needed the help. He helped me with my fishing setup throughout the whole day to be sure that I was able to gather fish alongside him. I am so grateful for having that experience with him. Had I not, I don't think I would have shared such a great passion in fishing as he did. But anytime I cast a line, I want you to know I'm thinking about you, Grandpa. I love you, and today I see how much of an impact you've truly made on others. And for that, I'm so thankful to call you my Grandpa. Until I see you again, we all love you and can't wait to be fishing in the high heavens beside you.
I believe one of the sisters said he was a fisher of men. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before we close the service, I just want to remind everybody on the back table, there's a box for memories. If you want to write any memories of Brother Frank, and then I encourage you, take these with you. Take these with you. And no matter what you may think, these things do work. Amen. They will land on the fertile ground that they're supposed to land on. Amen. The family has asked me to invite you all. There's a reception across the way. Just go out and across the courtyard. There's a reception there. So please, we invite you to, the family invites you to join them there. And we're going to close out our service with a final prayer. And if you'd like to, when the song starts playing, if you want to come express your condolences to the family, please come on up. And they're right here. So, and we'll have time over there across the way too. So if you don't catch them here, you will be able to catch them over there. Amen. So you could all stand, amen, as we close out, if you're able to stand. And I'm going to close out with Psalms 23, if that's okay with you. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sakes. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. The service is ended. Go in the peace of the Lord. Amen.
Are you disappointed? Are you desperate for help? You know what it's like to be tired and only a shell of yourself. You start to believe you don't have what it takes, 'cause it's all you can do just to move, much less finish the race. But don't forget what lies ahead. Jesus in us, it's not if, but when. So take joy in the journey.